For nearly all of human existence, we have lived in balance with the wild animals around us. They were essential for food, clothing, medicine, labor, and for all aspects of our livelihoods. They were fundamental to our very existence. But 10,000 years ago, with agricultural development and the domestication of animals, this all began to change. As our numbers grew, we began to overexploit wildlife resources and destroy and degrade wild habitats. The wild animal population quickly shrank. The Earth's animal biomass used to be 99% wild animals. Today, it is just 4%. Since the rise of civilization, humans have caused the loss of over 80% of all wild mammals. One in four mammal species are currently on the brink of extinction. Yet today, many communities all around the world still rely on wild animals for survival and as a central part of their livelihoods. For many communities in tropical and subtropical regions, wild meat provides for more than 50% of protein intake. Trade in reptile skins, meat, and other body parts of over 20 species across Southeast Asia contributes to the livelihoods of millions of people. For many, it is their only source of cash income. We're at a critical point in time. Sustainability must be achieved. We know it can be done, and we know how to do it. In the Andes, effective community-based wildlife management has brought back vicuña populations from 10,000 individuals in 1960 to almost 350,000 in 2012. In Namibia, putting the power to protect wildlife in the hands of local communities has helped build a better life for animals, the environment, and people, and generates significant benefits for over 200,000 conservancy inhabitants. In Louisiana, the sustainable harvest of over 600,000 eggs per year from a large and growing population of wild American alligators generates income for private landowners, who in consequence keep this habitat in its natural state, protecting it from profit-driven coastal development. Worldwide, organizations are tackling many wildlife issues, such as human-wildlife conflict, illegal wildlife trade, transmission of diseases, and climate change. What is now needed is a coordinated effort, one that is knowledge-based and focuses our best scientific and policy expertise to work with local people and indigenous cultures to achieve practical, long-term solutions. One initiative that can help is the Collaborative Partnership on Sustainable Wildlife Management. The CPW is a voluntary partnership of international organizations that serves as an important forum to discuss key global issues related to sustainable use, management, and conservation of terrestrial wildlife. The CPW works together with its members and local players worldwide to develop joint initiatives and collaborative activities to generate a better understanding of the multiple benefits and values of wildlife, and to support the development of strategies and policies to conserve wildlife and benefit the people who depend on wild resources for their survival and livelihoods. Together, we are stronger. Together, we can thrive.